our morning rounds, changes on the breakfast menu. Americans are waking up and eating differently. The Wall Street Journal is looking at what we want for breakfast and why entrenched habits are shifting. Dennis Berman is the Journal's business editor. Welcome.
Hi, Charlie.
So great, what's going on here with cereal? Poor people who want.
We're giving up
on
cereal.
Don't make us give up the Honey Nut Cheerios, Dennis.
Poor Kellogg. They talk to their investors and say we can't sell enough cereal. What's happening is that people are getting very concerned about carbohydrates, right, and they want to find protein. And so they're switching away from cereal, trying to find frozen egg sandwiches. They're going to fast food places. Taco Bell is selling waffles with eggs in them, so it's really a societal.
These things are better for them than cereals?
Well, we think they are. You know, I was on here a few weeks ago talking about how people feel better emotionally when they make these changes. So that, there's some debate to that.
But the cereal companies are fighting back because they're saying, look, if you put milk in your cereal, that is a form of protein.
It is a form of protein.
Cheerios has even come out with something that says Cheerios protein for the first
and
time.
It was fascinating to see the Kellogg CEO talk about how he had to make that proposition better to customers. Like, hey, when you have milk in your cereal, there will be more protein, and there, in fact, General Mills is rolling out a Cheerios protein, and there's a huge protein sign on it, just in case you might miss the message.
So cereals are on the decline, Greek yogurt and frozen breakfasts on the rise.
Definitely. So overall, frozen foods are actually going down. People are less interested in frozen foods, but when it comes to breakfast, they're willing to spend on those frozen foods. Why? Mm-hmm. And this, to me, is the important thing about breakfast, is that people do not have the time. I'm sure people watching right this moment are nodding their heads saying, we do not have the time for breakfast.
You're saying so, 12 minutes.
12 minutes. Those are the latest numbers. We supposedly spent 24 minutes on dinner, 26 minutes on lunch, or thereabouts. And to me, this is the real takeaway, that people don't have time. And why don't they have time? Because more women are working, more women with young children are working, and more baby boomers are working. And so when we look one step back, our standard of living just a little bit is, you know, sort of deteriorating. We don't have time to sit down.
And yet, can I just say, I just think breakfast is the most important meal of the day.
I've heard you say that 1,000 times.
Are you tired of hearing it, Charlie?
No, I've been around enough.
What were you going to say?
I was going to say two things. One, are you suggesting that breakfast is an increasing revenue source for all these companies?
Yes.
Except for cereals, where it's declining.
It is.
But there's a more focus on breakfast.
So the big fast food companies
are no longer just doing hamburgers, they're doing eggs.
Right. Well, Taco Bell wants to sell you a waffle with eggs.
Exactly right. My second question is, I thought the problem with cereals was sugar.
That is part of the problem. Again, people want to see that word protein. They want to eat protein, so they're eating more yogurt. But you take a step back, we have less time to do the things we love and, you know, the things that are important, because we're working harder. Not to get too deep on you all, but
I'm trying to spend more time doing the things I love.
Me too. Exactly.
But it's harder.
Her thing was at 10 minutes for breakfast. That was just way out of line.
Yeah. So I still think cereal is an important because it's fortified with vitamins. Milk
fortified,
is
it really?
Fortified.
That's what I've always said about cereal.
No, I agree. Don't you agree, Gail?
Yeah, I do.
Gail, me out here. I'm under assault.
All right, I'll help you out here. 10%.
How a Port of Floyd works.
10% of people aren't eating breakfast at all. So if you even eat cereal and you don't feel happy about it, feel better than those 10%.
Thank you. This is fun.
Can you work with Charlie and Nora?
We have some Freudian problems. I'll let them work it out.